What you're seeing on the screen right now is the logo for our Connected Churches program. It is powered by Google in a partnership that was created by Google back in 2016, 2017, and 2018. Next slide. So I want to talk a little bit about the goals of Connected Churches. The first goal was to make church a place of opportunity. We want people to be able to come to a place where they know and trust and learn and grow their digital skills. The thing that we're all talking about is the fact that technology is not going away. Not only is it not going away, it is a vital institution that we have to have in order to survive in the 21st century. And we understand that with the digital divide, we don't have that opportunity for everyone. So we want the church to be that place of opportunity. The goals of Connected Church is to provide local churches with tools, resources, and capabilities to maximize their effectiveness in all their ministry areas and utilizing the benefits of technology. Basically, we want you all to integrate this vital technology into the operations of your church. Make it part of your church DNA. And we have put together free resources that will allow you to do that seamlessly and professionally. And also, the Connected Churches program is to link tech to the faith-based civil rights legacy. We want to create a positive brand through a national campaign led by Rainbow Push and the wonderful Reverend Jesse Jackson. This campaign is to highlight the tech industry's commitment to closing the digital divide, as well as Rainbow Push's commitment to pushing the digital divide. And then we want you, the church family, to understand your role and to help build your capacity in that role in closing the digital divide. Next slide. So I want to give you all a little context. We're talking about this digital divide and digital inequity, and we're thinking about our students, we're thinking about our kids, we're thinking about our seniors. And so here's a few numbers that, for those of us that appreciate visuals and numbers, that talks about the current statistics that are happening right now today. And the fact that 46% of Black American households do not have broadband internet in their homes. So in order for you to be able to be a part of the digital inclusion revolution, you have to have broadband. We know now that most jobs have to be applied for online, but 56% of those jobs actually require some level of computer or digital skills. We're thinking about COVID-19 and our children having to go virtual within a matter of days, but yet 12 million of our students across the country do not have internet or computer at home. We think about our seniors, and that a lot of our seniors are getting smartphones and tablets. And what I found when I've taught many seniors is that most of the time their kids or grandkids have given them this piece of technology and they have it, but not necessarily know how to use it effectively. And this last statistic that I just found is that 53% of Americans says the internet has been essential during this COVID-19 crisis. And I would surmise to say that 100% of Americans needed technology during this pandemic. And so once again, this program, which was conceived before COVID-19, is to help churches become that place of opportunity and that place of knowledge and learning. Next slide. So presenting now is a little snapshot of the content that our toolkit and website provides. Since this was a Google-powered project, most of the tools are based on the Google platform. The great thing about the Google platform, as far as productivity and connectivity and communication, most of all of their resources are free to the public and to your church. All you need is the Gmail address, which is why I have the Gmail highlighted here. It is so important that we have email addresses, particularly Gmail. And one of the things that we will help you do and assist you with doing is not only assisting you with creating your Gmail, but if you already have a Gmail, we can assist you with using your Gmail in optimum fashion, and also assist you with learning how to use all the other different tools that Gmail and Google opens up to you once you have that free email. What I want to be able to also say while we're having this is, if you have any questions, please go ahead and put it in our Q&A in our chat. And at the end of the presentation, we will answer a few of your questions with the time that it's allotted. But this is an amazing, amazing platform. And we have been able to take those lessons and concentrate it in one place so that you can learn and grow your church, your ministry, your staff, and your community. Next slide. So this is also another brief snapshot of what the Connected Churches program is providing for you. You can get one-to-one support from the specialist, myself, and Minister Dallas, and other professionals at the Rainbow Push Silicon Valley office will be available to you in order for you to build your capacity and do some knowledge. We can do train the trainer workshops. Obviously, right now in the time of COVID, those will be virtual, but this will allow you and me and us to help you learn these things if you don't already know them. Now, if you already have a good capacity for all of these tools, we want to assist you with taking your ministry to the next level and be able to teach the congregation in your church. And if your congregation in your church is pretty tech savvy, well, then we want to assist you with taking your ministry to the next level by providing consistent and relevant classes that you can teach the community at broad. Like we said, we want the church to be that place of opportunity, because unfortunately, we can't give everybody free internet and free laptops. But what we can do is give them a place where they can learn and enhance their lives. And we can also provide limited technical assistance. And I'm going to say that's going to be for mostly my counterpart, Mr. Dallas. So at this time, we're going to take a few moments to actually hop on our Connected Churches website so you can look at it live and take a look at those different things. And so I want you all to know that this is a passion project for me. This is part of my purpose. This is my God-given purpose. So I come to you as a woman of faith and a woman with a love for the community. And I appreciate any questions or comments. I know I have a couple of professionals maybe logged in. So we are open to adding to our knowledge so that we can bring this resource out to different communities and churches. So this is our toolkit. This is our Connected Churches toolkit. And it is, was created by our partnership with Google. And it was an idea from Reverend Jackson. As Pastor Brian explains, Reverend Jackson understood the need for African Americans to be a part of this technology revolution. And so we have presented and created this toolkit over the last few years and presented it, promoted it, preached it and even pushed it, pun intended, to denominational conferences. We've given this to district denominational conferences. We've also presented this at many Rainbow Push summits, as well as several Rainbow Push international summits and workshops and conferences. And so this is, you know, a fantastic free resource. And in the time of COVID, it is almost essential. And so as we scroll down, these are some of the links and things that you will be able to access when you hop on to our website. The toolkit is downloadable. So you can actually click on download the toolkit and you can actually save that on the device. I know some of us still like paper and pencil. I personally still like paper and pencil. So the fact that it's downloadable is very convenient to me so that I can read on paper and not necessarily a screen. And so that is accessible and available to you free of charge. We want to go to this I want to section, which is phenomenal because it actually breaks down specific things that churches may want to do or use in this technology. And we're going to go and click into one of them, which is I want to create videos at church. And so when you click on this, this goes to the amazing technology that is YouTube. I know some of you are watching and listening to us live on YouTube, and we appreciate you taking the time to give us your time. And so YouTube is an amazing technology that will allow you to upload videos of your church services online. You not only can stream live services, you can also upload those services and then allow people to come and watch them at a later time. It is free to have your YouTube channel, and it doesn't take much energy to be able to set up live and streaming video. You can get with your AV team and create a page, create a channel. And then you have a backlog and a archive of all your different sermons and preachings. Here's the deal. Back in the day when we had revival service or we had our Easter service, we would print them out on tapes and print them out on CDs and print them out on VHSs and all sorts of things. And now, we don't really have to do that anymore. Now we can just stream live and you can save and have your film for years and years and years to come. If you want to take your YouTube to the next level, you can get it to the point where YouTube will pay you in order to have people watch your videos. And that's next level, but and for the beginning, this service is open and available to you right now, this second. You can do this right now with your church family. And you think about your seniors or your sick and shut in who may not have the ability to come to the church. And of course, in COVID, no one is able to come to the church, or people are going back and forth as to whether or not they're ready to go back to church. And so this is a resource that will allow you to continue to spread the word of God, to continue to send out the love of Christ to your parishioners, to your congregation, to your members. And it's easy and it is free. So going back to the main page, I can show you, or we can show you, all of the modules that are available for you to learn different things. Each one of these are clickable, and it will give you a short introductory lesson into using all of these tools. The Bible app is a very important app for congregations and pastors. I love the YouVersion Bible app. It's probably my primary Bible. It allows you to be able to highlight scriptures. It allows you to be able to find lesson plans based on your scriptures. You're able to identify entire Bible school around the scriptures and the lessons that are available in this particular Bible app. This is one, there are others, but this one here is my favorite. And so this is, once again, free for you to use, for you to use as pastors and leaders, and for your congregations and your community. It is a greatly an amazing tool. Also, in those liturgy modules, you can also see where we have more of the Google platforms. Google Docs is an amazing feature that allows you to, say, type up your sermons or type up the agenda for Easter or pastor's anniversary or whatever it is that you need to do a doc. It's Google's version of Microsoft Word. And so the most amazing thing that I love about all the Google tools, including the SlideShow presentations and the Excel documents, is they have a great collaborative feature so that you don't have to always have everyone in the room in order to make things happen. In the time of COVID, where we have to social distance, it'll be great if you can pull up a Google Doc and your minister of music or your vacation Bible school coordinator or your Sunday school coordinator, you all have the ability to hop on the same document in completely different houses and work on it in real time. How great is that for efficiency? How great is that? Because we don't want Sister Johnson, who isn't feeling well and can't come to the church, now we can't figure out how to get the pastor's anniversary completed because she's sick. Yep, she can actually hop on and make notes live while everyone is talking together. And so we are here to help. We are here to let you know that we want you to have these tools. We want you to integrate these tools into your worship, into your operations, into your logistics, and into your ministry. And as I said before, if you are good with that and your church is good with that, we want you to take your knowledge and bring this knowledge to your community. To be that place where children who have to do homework and don't have a computer at home can come to the church and use your computers and the internet so they can learn how to code and have programming. And so going back to our slides, I want to let you know that this website, theconnectedchurches.org, is available to you. But one of the amazing things about theconnectedchurches.org, as if I have not told you enough amazing things, is that you can actually make an appointment to speak with one of the specialists. We want you to be able to contact us and set up a meeting where we will build your capacity, do a needs assessment to figure out what you need, and then assist you with either finding resources or building resources so that you can affect your ministry. This is ministry. This is just not this thing in the world. This is like radio, when radio was a thing and we had radio broadcasts, which we still have radio broadcasts. This is just like television, when television was an essential communication tool to spread the love of Christ. Now we have the internet. The internet now is an essential tool that the body of Christ needs in order to continue to spread the love of Christ and to bring opportunity to the community.